It's fall in New England, the time of year when all the leaves change from green to red, yellow, and orange. But did you ever wonder why that transition happens? Hi, I'm Chlorophyll, the pigment that gives leaves their characteristic green color. I'm on a mission to find out why every year in the fall the leaves change from this beautiful green shade to all of those other colors. My friend Brad is gonna show us how to find out exactly why all of those color changes happen. But first, we need to talk about something I like to call photosynthesis.
So let's talk about photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process that plants use to produce food. To conduct photosynthesis, plants need three things. First, they need water. They draw water up through their roots and bring it into their leaves. Secondly, plants need carbon dioxide. Third, and perhaps most important, plants need energy, and they get that energy from sunlight. Plants absorb sunlight through their leaves using several pigments. The primary pigment, chlorophyll, is what gives plants its green appearance. With those three things, water, carbon dioxide, and sunlight, plants conduct photosynthesis, and the output of that chemical reaction is glucose, which is a sugar that plants need to stay alive. A byproduct of photosynthesis, in addition to glucose, is oxygen. So really, if you look at it, chlorophyll is a critical piece to the photosynthesis puzzle because it gives plants the energy to produce food that they need and to produce oxygen that we as humans need.
Okay, I get it. I get what you're saying, Brad. I'm pretty much awesome at making food.
Well, sorry to tell you, Chlorophyll, but you're not that special. There are two other pigments that are in every leaf. There's an orange-red pigment called carotene and a yellow pigment called xanthophyll. During the summer, when there's more light, trees will produce more of you, so the leaves will appear green, but there is still carotene and xanthophyll inside each leaf.
You can't be serious.
Absolutely I am.
So you're saying that even a green leaf has all these other pigments in it, but they still look green because there's so much chlorophyll?
Yep, right now, even inside of you, there's all three pigments. You just wouldn't know it.
I'm sorry, I just don't believe you. That doesn't even make sense.
Well, if you don't believe me, I'll take you to a laboratory and we'll prove it with science.
So we're here in the lab. We're going to do the chromatography experiment.
Wow, I'm excited.
Yeah, me too. So chromatography is a process that you can use to isolate pigments in a leaf. And it was first performed in 1901 by a man named Mikhail Svet.
Whoa, okay, that guy's old.
It's very old. And that was the first time anyone proved there are multiple pigments in every leaf. And so we're going to recreate his famous experiment here using materials that you can find around your house.
Awesome. I guess that means anybody can do it.
Absolutely.
Even people at home.
So the things you're going to need are a pair of scissors, a ruler, three pencils, some scotch tape, a coin for each person that's in the experiment, a whole bunch of leaves of all the different colors, some filter paper. Here, we're just using basic coffee filters, rubbing alcohol, and then we're going to need glasses, one glass for each person that's in the experiment. So step one, take a piece of filter paper.
Okay.
We're going to cut out long, skinny strips between a half an inch to an inch wide. They need to be at least as long as your cups are tall. Step two, you want to take your ruler and you want to measure out a distance of about 2 centimeters from the bottom of each of your strip and draw a line using pencil. Okay, so once we have our long, skinny strips, the next step is to get pigment onto it. You're going to start with a red leaf or a green leaf in your case, and you're going to set it down so that the top of the leaf is facing up.
Okay.
Put your filter paper over the top of it where you've drawn the little line, and then take your coin and roll it across the top of the filter paper. And you should see, even after sort of your first roll, that some of the pigment from the leaf has transferred onto the filter paper. So you want to get a lot of pigment, because the more pigment you get, the better it's going to be when we do the experiment. So once you've done that, since we're using two pieces of paper, pick another leaf and do the same thing. So now you should have two strips of paper with a really bright color pigment line on each of them.
Oh yeah.
All right. Now that we're at that point, take your other pencils, not the one that we were writing with, but the extra ones.
Thank you.
We're going to use this as sort of a platform that we're going to attach these to so that they can rest in the cup. So what you want to do is take them and tape each of them, the end that you didn't put the pigment on, tape those to your pencil.
Okay, ready to go.
Okay, so the next step is to test out this in your cup. So what you want to do is take it and rest it right across the top.
What you want to make sure is that the lengths of your piece of paper, when it's completely straight, just barely touch the bottom. So, now we're ready to start the experiment.
All right.
Last step is to take some rubbing alcohol. You want to put enough in to get the tips of your paper wet, but not enough so that it actually touches your pigment.
Got it.
Okay, you ready to do the experiment?
So ready.
All right, let's drop it in. Well, it's been like 15 minutes. You want to take a look at it, see how they look?
I'm so ready for this. So this one was the plain green leaf.
Yep.
And I've got a whole lot of colors that I wasn't expecting to see. What am I looking at here?
So you'll see the first band, the green, is chlorophyll, which is what you'd expect. But what's interesting is that above it, there's a yellow line, and that's the xanthophyll, the yellow pigment. So even in a leaf that looked green, there's actually a little bit of pigment that you didn't even know was there.
The leaf that I did next to it, that's the halfway red and halfway green leaf. I see a lot more red in my coloring there.
That's the carotene, yep. But that one, because it's starting to turn, it wasn't masked by the green.
Okay. Well, what about yours?
So you can see in our red leaf,
you see
a whole lot of dark red.
That is really vibrant.
Yeah, and you don't actually even see much of anything else because it's already turned, and so the chlorophyll's been lost. And in our other one, which was the yellow leaf, you can see a band of yellow, the xanthophyll, as you'd expect.
Yeah, the yellow's quite strong.
But right underneath it, there's a band of green chlorophyll.
There is some green in there!
So even in the yellow guy, there was still a little bit of chlorophyll.
And then you see a little bit of red up above it, too.
Yeah, so there was even a little bit of red, even though it was a yellow leaf. Which is pretty cool.
Who knew?
Yeah.
There's just so many different colors in every leaf.
Well, thanks so much, Brad, for teaching me about chromatography.
Yeah, no problem. Wasn't that a cool experiment?
It was really sweet.
I mean, even with just like the simple household stuff, we were able to prove that every leaf, regardless of its color, has pigments of all of them.
I know. I mean, who even knew those other pigments were out there?
I know, right?
Well, I feel like I learned a lot today. I learned how to do chromatography with all these different kinds of pigment, and I learned that actually fall is kind of a cool season.
Yeah, no, it is.
And probably most importantly, I learned that those other leaves are pretty awesome. They really know how to have a good time.
They do.
Hey! I love the fall!
Fall is so much fun!
Leaf dance!
Leaf dance!
Go, leaves!
I like to go with the wind and fly, and I can visit other places.
Chlorophyll is nice. She's so green. She's not as colorful as me, though.
It might be my new favorite thing. I might start doing chromatography daily.
Well, you know, I had a good time making it, but honestly, those leaves, they're not very professional.
It's just been a really nice friendship. Do you guys want to say something about our friendship?
I love you guys.
I love you!
I love you too!
I love you.
We like you too, Xanthophyll. All right.